What's up, everyone? I hope you're all doing well. Welcome to a live broadcast. Just give me a few seconds here. I'm going to wear my old man glasses, unfortunately, because I'm blind. I won't be able to read your comments. Just give me a moment. I am trying to post this so everyone can see it. Where is the... Where is the link for this thing? Just bear with me, folks. All right, here we go. Okay. I'm just, putting this link where I need to. So just give me a little bit to get this thing started, because it's been a long time since I've started one of these things. So just bear with me. Just bear with me. I also have the binaural microphones in. So this should be the left side, and this should be the right side. Hopefully that works out. Just give me a second here. All right. I got y'all's comments here. That's good. All right, so that's a success. All right, what's up, Seals, Samuel, Mobius, the Brutal Player, Ciro, Silto, Pedro, Isilium, Peaceful Mind. All right. Okay. I think I'm good to go here. I'm trying to spam this thing everywhere I can. So, in case anybody's, my God, I'm not logged into all my different places on here. I hate my computer. All right. Just give me a second, folks. I know this is thrilling right now. Oh my God. I'm such a professional. All right. Hold on a second here. Just give me a minute. Just all right. All right. Dark Chav Slayer, Akan, Ghost Rider. Thanks for watching. Thanks for everyone that watches and stuff. Thank you, Metal Gear. Fjorkvar. I'm probably going to stick to streaming on YouTube for now until I can figure out how to stream on Twitch. I mean, I have a Twitch account over there, but... I have a Twitch account, but I haven't really figured out the software yet to use. So we'll see. If anyone has questions or whatever, you know, you want to talk about something. This isn't anything really special. It's just, you know, kind of hang out. You know, if you got some questions, if you want a topic to talk about. I also have like paper cups. This should be broadcasting in binaural, I hope. Like there should be some separation here, I hope, from the for the mics. So, but hopefully that's like the left side. And over here should be like, right side or the left side, I don't know, whatever. It's probably gonna be flip-flopped a little bit between the webcam and the audio and blah blah blah. So so I don't know if these comments are supposed to refresh here. It's taking a little bit of time, I think, for me to get any of your comments, just so you know. And so, like I said, I'm just going to eat some pizza because I haven't had any lunch today. I actually had to go to our old place. And I don't have any napkins either. Oh, man, I'm so unprepared. Hold on, I'm right back. I gotta get napkins, man. Oh, yes. So, I gotta post this. I also have, besides the pizza, yummy pizza that I'm gonna eat in front of you and just make you go crazy. Here you can see delicious pizza. Yum, 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 yum. Pizza cam. There you go. Nom, nom, nom. So, I'm gonna eat this. I'm gonna hang out. And if you have questions and stuff, answer them. Now I'm looking at the comments here on the YouTube. Oh man, there's a ton of comments. All right. I also have this beer. It's a, let me see where it's out of. And what the heck is this beer of? It's a Blanche de Bruelles. I don't know. I probably just butchered that. You know me. I can't speak anything besides American. Oh, it's a Belgian. It's a Belgian beer. There you go. Blanche, I guess. Blanc. Yeah. Nice little boy taking a wee wee on the wheat beer. Probably gives it extra flavor. So check this out. It's got 4.5% ABV. Doesn't really say anything else. Traditional world recipe, unique unmalted wheat, refreshing, and famous Belgian ingredients, barley, and soft yellow color, sour sweet taste. All right. So I'm going to pop this open, and then I'm going to get to your comments and such. Hello, Travers. Drinking a Tyski, I think. Tyski? Yes, I remember the beer. I think it was a good beer. I kind of remember it. Epic. I'm going to be getting another CFX mask. Yes, it's going to be a devil type mask, because I want to do a deal with the devil. Some folks had asked for a role play where, basically sell your soul for the devil. So I'm going to play the devil in that. And then I want to do I can't think straight right now. Oh yeah, Krampus video. Hey Dazer from Portugal. Drog wants to know, what was that video posted on Halloween? I didn't post a video on Halloween. I'm not sure what you're talking about. Is the monster your roommate? I saw the pumpkin. Is the monster your roommate? No, just me, my wife, and my son. No. Let's see. What type of music do I like? Says Metagear. Can I integrate music elements into the video? I thought about that. Having some nice background music and such, maybe introduction, some like a soundtrack. That takes a lot of work. I've thought about it here and there, so we'll see. I know some of you don't drink. So apologies for those of you who don't drink or whatever. If you can see that, it almost looks the same on camera as it does here. It's like a creamy gold color. It's a little dirty on the video, but you can see carbonation. Maybe there's some carbonation there a little bit. Smells like a nice, almost smells like, what's that Belgian beer that looks like this? I can't think of it offhand. It's got a lot of particles floating in it, unless that's because my glass is dirty, but I don't think that's the case. Maybe it was. No, this was in my cabinet, so. There you go. Cheers. Cling. Hey, Indigo Stars. If you're still watching, thanks for watching. I love your stuff. Check out Indigo Stars' channel if you haven't had a chance to yet. She's like, I think she is a real vampire, actually. Was my opinion on bodybuilders, says Gold X605. I have no problem with anybody. I just have a problem with anybody that forces themselves onto you, whether it's religion or, whatever it might be. I have no problem with people that work out. Bodybuilders, weightlifting. I have a problem with anyone that might be a little too extreme, with whether it's you know, being too macho or something like that, you know. That's all. I'm just looking through the comments here. Guy 0987, hello. Hello, NSR Entertainment Channel. Hi, Virtual Game Desk, thank you. Let me see. So if you've got any questions or whatever, you know, feel free to ask. Carbano Gaming says, go Seahawks. I used to be a Cowboys fan. I don't really watch much football anymore, but Kiroptera says, hi, Rift. Hey, I don't have any beer and pizza, but I have burritos and Pepsi. Hey, that works. Whatever you got. 53VW says, PS3 controller. Where's my PS3 controller? It's around here somewhere. I don't have it on me. Not this. Bubble wrap. You probably don't want to hear that. Christian Torres, what music do I listen to? I listen to everything, really. By the way, this is a great beer. It's delicious. I'm trying to think of that Belgian beer that I had. That's almost the same, that wheat beer. God, the name is not Blue Moon, I don't think. Anyway. What music do I listen to? Anything. I mean, Michael Jackson. You know, I love the 80s. I grew up, was a teen in the 80s, so I love all that. That 80s music was great. I primarily enjoy metal, progressive metal. I like Soen, S-O-E-N, you know, Tool. Carnival, I guess. You know, besides that, I also, you know, I like classical music. I don't own any albums though, but I mean, I like, you know, classical stuff. I like, you know, Celtic, you know, I like folk, blues. I like the blues. I like jazz. I like the bluegrass. I like bluegrass. Some country. I don't like pop country or anything. I kind of like old school country, maybe, you know. You know, I've listened to like Reba McEntire. What's his name? I can't think of his name. Johnny Cash. You know, there's some folks like that. World music. I like, I've listened to Chemical Brothers, electronic music like that, you know, some rap. Primarily, you know, what's, you know, what I listen to is, like I said, mostly progressive metal. And also like Kid Rock. I like that one album, The Devil Without a Cause album. I'm open to anything, really. It just depends on my mood. Isaac Larson wants to know, is it socially acceptable for a 17-year-old male to wear a Homburg bowler hat? Well, yeah. I think that goes without saying. What's up, Wayne V? 111. That beard makes me look really old. Good. I'm glad. What was my favorite beer? I don't really have a favorite. Pinking Gaming. Really, honestly, I like porters and I like porters and stouts because they're rich. I love anything in life that's rich, you know. And I like dark, my coffee black, you know. Aside from the porters and the stouts, I like these beers. I like these Belgian wheat beers are good. I know it's a white beer. It says it's a white beer. For those of you who may just be joining, I'm drinking this. The camera can pick it up there. It says it's a white beer. I'm assuming that means it's wheat beer. I mean, but then it says ingredients barley. So I don't know. I guess it's not a wheat beer, but it kind of almost seems the same to me. I don't know my difference between my wheats and my barleys and my hops. So... Ghost Rider 2ification wants to know if I ever checked out Post Rock. Do you have any bands to recommend? I don't know if I've ever actually listened to any Post Rock. I mean, maybe I did, but I just didn't know. Steve Wright says, I overheard my dad talking to his friend about how the whole celebration of Halloween and trick-or-treating is a bad thing. Basically, it teaches kids in life that they should get good things, and that if they don't, they should do something bad. It also essentially encourages begging. What do you think about the CR? I don't. I mean, it all depends on the parent, really. I mean, you. I don't really think it. You know. I don't. It. You know. I didn't. Ever feel that way when I went trick-or-treating in our son, you know, I mean, it's kind of like a thing where kids expect to get treats and goodies at Halloween, you know, we get dressed up and stuff, but I don't think it's a big deal. I think it's fun, you know, it's kind of a fun thing to do, and it's just giving the candies a part of it. I mean, you want to analyze it and look at it and say that it's a, you know, where kids expect free things and all this stuff. And, you know, that I think that just comes back to the types of parents. I mean, so, you know, I don't think it's a big deal, really. Gummy Wums. Is the Katana Chick, Michonne, your favorite Walking Dead character? I think so. There's something about a woman, you know, being strong, you know, that I like. Because you don't, as far as like in the movies and such, you know, it's just something you don't ever get to see. It's always the guys are tough and the heroes. So I like Rick this season. Looks like he's back to his badass self. Yeah, Rick and then Michonne, and everybody loves Daryl, right? At least most of the women do. Dang women's. But Rick and Michonne are pretty much my favorite characters on the show. Thanks for your question. What is my favorite character to play? Asks Fjorkvar Wolfhearth. And I'm getting to your questions kind of behind, just because there's a lot. So Thank you. But my favorite character to play, I like the Plague Doctor. I like Dave. You know, Clemens. I mean, I like most of them. Margaret. You know, I pretty much like most of them. So, just a matter of getting around to them all, I guess. Am I going to continue the Limbo playthrough? Yeah. I know I'm primarily doing the aliens, Alien Isolation. I want to kind of intersperse that with some of the other games that I've played. So I still want to do Limbo and Skyrim and Eidolon and Fallout. For some reason, my Fallout is not loading when I go to load it through Steam. We have a little box that says play, and I hit play, and then with a little Windows circle icon, and then it never loads. So I don't know what the heck happened there. So I'm kind of afraid that something got corrupted and I got to restart all over again. So. This bruise, no, this is not a bruise. This is like allergies. I don't know what the hell happened. This morning I woke up. It's just allergies, a little bit of a breakout. There's some pimples there. It's not, I didn't get a fight with Dave or Professor or anything like that. But it's, it looks nastier, but it's not that bad. I just had to get some allergy medicine and clear that up. But thanks for asking. So. Unfortunately, I am human, and I do have imperfections once in a while, believe it or not. Marcus Kinney wants to know if I went to college, and did I like it? Never went to college. Finished high school, and then just couldn't figure out what to do with myself. So I went and got a job and became part of the workforce, and I've been working ever since. Well, I've had jobs before. I finished high school. I worked at McDonald's. I used to bag groceries at supermarkets. I was a cook at McDonald's. I was a short order cook, very brief period of time for a very small pub. Just starting out. That wasn't anything. Just cooking cheesesteaks and stuff. That didn't last long. And then I got a job. It's somewhat customer service related, somewhat computer related, but I'm not a programmer or anything. And and that's what I was good at, and that's what I did. Meanwhile, for the past from my 20s till now, just frustrated artistically or creatively. I didn't want to just work a job, and I wanted to do something creatively with my life. But I didn't really figure out what that was, at least until now. And I guess this is what I want to do, or it's going to lead me somewhere else. I don't know, but this is where I'm at right now. So it keeps me from going insane. So, nice. Kiwi bird's going to grab some cake. Awesome. I'm very jealous. I'd rather have cake, I think. I'd rather eat a whole cake than pizza. So, Peaceful Mind, how did I ever come up with the different voices for my various characters? Thank you. They're so unique. I just try to look at the thing and try to think, how that would look and sound. Clemens is supposed to be like the reserved, polite, yet maniacal kind of doctor, I guess. The ghoul, Mordecai, he's a ghoul, So I gotta try to do that voice. The zombie voice, the zombie. The heck is his name? I forget. I can't remember his name. Was it Frank Walker? I think that's the name I gave him. I'm just trying to do a voice that suited what he looked like, that's pretty much how I do it. It's hard to do a lot of voices. I don't, I'm not like an expert or anything like this, but I just, every video is an experiment for the most part, I don't put too much practice into beforehand. I don't do a lot of, I get the mask or I get the outfit or whatever the prop is, and then 10 minutes, 15 minutes trying to figure out what voice to give it, and then I kind of roll with it. So the hard part is trying to remember what that voice was and then trying to redo it again, because that's kind of difficult. All right, somebody said they wanted to hear the bubble wrap. So this is into a little bubble wrap. The bubble wrap, I'm eating pizza. I think I can do two things at once. Now you can't really see. I just have a styrofoam head right here. And this is, I'll show you. It's getting a little noisy. So I'll try not to be so noisy. All right. This is my professional Hollywood setup here, right? So this is what I got. I got this head off of eBay. Not Amazon. This is the white male head. I got this. The heck is this? It's vinyl. It's a vinyl material. It's what I purchased to make straps for my steampunk goggles. So it has this other side to it. And then it has right here corn cob, just to keep in place. See how pro this is? This is so pro, I'm telling you. All right, so that kind of keeps the fabric back, so the fabric doesn't, and I just dug out the ear holes with a knife, so pro, and I popped in the binaural mic in that ear, and I cut off his nose, because he was like, I would like to have my nose cut off, so I said, all right, I can do that for $5, and then actually, so I could attach the GoPro. But I don't really use the GoPro that much. And then that's the other mic in there. And I'm just using this particular head for this session. I hope that's not too loud. I'm killing you guys. I have another one. I don't use this one because the other one that I have, I just spray painted that. I don't know why. The other one I have is all white and it has a hole right in his face where I can put my camera in. And this is the camera that I use. A lot of people have asked. It's that old. Hopefully that's to me, it's reversed. Hopefully you can read the writing. This is just an HD camcorder. I bought it back in 2011. It doesn't come with this part. This part is just part of the part, part of my tripod, actually. It's a quick release plate. So it clicks onto the tripod head, and then you can, the little switch, take it off if you need to. This thing has been serving me well. You know, I mean, if I was looking to make videos or films, you know, for I don't want to get to your comments and stuff here, but I know some folks have asked what type of camera I use and such. You know, if I was looking to do, you know, Hollywood or a film for a real film to be released at a festival or something, well, then I would purchase something a little bit more better than this. But, you know, I haven't heard, you know, tons of complaints about the quality of my videos. So I don't really see too much of an investment just to get a more recent camera. You know, I've thought about it. I'd rather get props. I'd rather get stuff to make immersive set, so to speak, than just another piece of optics. Why upgrade this when it works fine? So, so yeah, that's it. Just typical. Yeah. What if I can do the thing where it's like, there we go. I almost got it. Wait. Where'd it go? Oh, I just had it. There it is. I don't know how to do that. All right, just trying to get the infinite screen after screen. Anyway, so yeah, that's what I use. And it just kind of goes right into the hole that I dug out of the other styrofoam head, and it sits in there. So, I mean, it's been serving me well, so I figured there's no real need to just buy another piece of equipment just to have a new thing. Why waste the money when that still works? And the video is coming out pretty well, I think. So, you know, invest the money somewhere else. So, all right, I know you got a lot of comments here. Epic Knives, do I play any instruments? No, I've taught myself how to play guitar. Like, I taught myself like 6 chords, you know, basic chords. You know, I can sit down and strum a little bit. I can play Native American flute. I've taught myself that. That's kind of fairly easy, simple to play. Well, to a degree, but that's really it. Travers wants to know if I'm a short-sighted or long-sighted person. But I think I'm just about both now, actually. My vision is getting worse when I take these off. Let's see. I can read that pretty clear. At about that distance, but anything arm's reach, it's getting. So I used to be able to see. So I guess that's nearsighted. I could see near well, and or farsighted. I forget, but I could never see far away clear. I first started wearing glasses when I was about was it 5th grade? 5th or 6th grade, I think I started wearing glasses. So I could never see far at that age. And now my vision, my close-up vision is getting worse too. So that's all right though, because, you know, 30 years from now, I'll just be doing blind ASMR, you know. So no offense to anybody out there, but yeah. Senile ASMR. Blixit Declerk. Hello, Rift. What's up? How much did you smoke weed before your son was born, and do you still smoke from time to time? Greetings from Belgium. I don't smoke right now. I've stopped before about 2 years before we knew we were going to have our son. And I only, you know, I smoked occasionally as a teen. I smoked occasionally in early 30s. It was a way for me to get a lot of my pent up. I was a very reserved person. I usually kept everything inside, and I felt that was a great release. So we stopped. I stopped smoking. And I, like I said, once a couple years, maybe I'd not like once a month. It was maybe once a year, and then maybe once every couple of years. It wasn't, I mean, that often. I don't feel I need it now. I feel much more free, so to speak, if that makes sense. And but if it ever becomes legal where I live and our son grows up and moves out, I don't know what will happen at that point. But I don't really see myself having to smoke again or wanting to. Juan Amaya wants to know if I ever feel my creativity restricted to ASMR, or is it like a good challenge for you? I'm not restricted to ASMR. I could do other things, but I like the medium. I like the ASMR medium because it's just so new. There's so much yet to be done. I mean, a full-length feature film, that's all the audio is nice and subdued, and there's no loud explosions and all that. This is just the tip of the iceberg, right? People have been trying to be creative in a lot of different ways. And it's great, but it's really just the tip, just the beginning. You know, ASMR isn't going anywhere. It's not really there's no ASMR channel yet on the radio. There's no TV channel ASMR geared. Is that in the future? I don't really know, but I like the medium. It's a challenge for me personally. That's how I see it. I like a good challenge. I like to see if I can challenge myself continuously. So, and not just with ASMR being creative, but just with learning, you know, in life, different philosophies, nihilism, anarchism, you know, challenge myself to be a better person, you know, things like that. So, Shabano, I think. Am I a fan of Stephen King? Yes. Well, not anymore. I mean, when Stephen King came out, I did enjoy, not when he came out, but I mean, back in the day, I guess. So I meant when he was fairly new, maybe. It, Misery, those are pretty much the two big books that I like by him. I haven't read anything else. Pretty much. Do I ever consider Ehab a Madris? Do I ever consider using special effects? Yeah, I have, but they're gimmicks to me. At least for these types of videos. You know, I think they have their place. The type of special effects I would like to do is like, you know, stop motion or, you know, I don't want to, I don't want to use just particle effects, or I don't even like using green screens. I don't want to just use it just because I can use it. Oh, look, I can use a green screen. Oh, look, special effects, blah, blah, blah. No, there's got to be a reason. There's a purpose for it. So, you know, I would like to incorporate. One of the ideas I have is doing a video where I'm in a Minecraft house. Actually, I have a pickaxe. So I'm going to do like a Minecraft role play where I'm like pretending I'm mining for something. Then we head back to the house. There's got to be a reason for me to do the special effects. And that's not like an excuse to say because I don't know how to do special effects. Yeah, I don't have the software, but I'm not going to just, you know, put some kind of particle, whatever, fancy thing, and just to do that for the sole purpose of doing this fancy thing. You know, so it's got to kind of fit. Hey, Calming Escape. Thanks for joining. If you're still there, I'm sorry, I'm really behind on the comments here. There's a lot of questions and stuff. So, I'm just trying to scroll through here. So, forgive me if it's taking me forever to get to you. I promise if you stay here for another 10 hours, we'll get to your question. Promise. 10 hours. That's all I need from your life and your money. Will I ever do a Fallout GOAT roleplay? Yes. I actually mentioned that months ago. I'm not sure how to do it as, who I'm going to do it as, but yeah, I want to do the GOAT. I haven't figured out how to do that. How I want to do it. So, hey Julius, Whisper for President asks, have I ever had the German beer Bitburger? Or another viewer asks, Oettinger, whatever. I'm not sure how to pronounce anything outside America, but I have not had that beer. Is it a dark beer, light beer? I don't know. I'll have to check it out. I'm almost finished this, the one I'm drinking, in case anybody missed it. Again, drinking this. It's pretty good. Do a Little Big Planet playthrough. Yeah, we have Little Big Planet, but let's see. All right, Tyler wants to know, do I like mashed or baked potatoes? That's a good question. See, mashed potatoes, right? You have garlic mashed potatoes. You can also have yams, well, sweet potatoes, mashed potatoes, mashed sweet potatoes. But of course, you'd always have a baked sweet potato too. Baked potatoes, you can't really do too much, right? Just a potato, and then you can put some stuff on top of it, but not quite the same. So I'm going to have to go with the mashed, especially garlic mashed potatoes. Thanks for your question, though. Can I walk across water? Not only can I walk across water, I can levitate across it, and I can swim through it. Hello from Russia. Hello. I cannot pronounce your name. It starts with a B. Zaradon. Hello. I'm a huge fan of body modification and body art. I was just wondering if you think you'll ever have piercings again or get any more tattoos, or is that something you feel that you've moved on from? Viking. I want to get sleeves, actually, of like Geiger-esque type stuff. I love that organic biomechanic type of thing. I love to get those done at some point, but you're talking a couple $1,000s each arm and time, and I don't know if I have that kind of patience. And I'm not really sure if that's where I want to put my money. Thought about getting my son, our son, tattooed somewhere in the, but you know. So the more tattoo, getting more tattooed is kind of on hold right now. Body piercings. I've had a ring here. I've had a labrette spike sticking out here. I've had an eyebrow ring. And I've had my ears pierced, and I would get those again. I think I like the brick, I like the spike, I like the ring, but I don't know. So I think I've kind of moved on from the piercings. I've had my nipple pierced too. That hurt. Of everything that I've had done, getting your nipple pierced was the worst thing ever. It wasn't like I was crying, but it was, pain was pretty bad. And they used a needle too. It wasn't like they used a gun or anything like that. But I'd like to get more tattoos, I think. But I think that's about it. Drivers wants to know what I think about Dimitri from Massage ASMR. I have no problem with him. What he does, you know, he's doing something right. He's got a lot of subscribers and stuff. So, do I see ASMR? Do I see making ASMR my career as a real possibility? And if so, would you want to study ASMR and why we get it? That's from Charlie Jupiter. Hi, and thanks. If I can do this or something like this or wherever this is leading as a career, then that's what I like to do. You know, I mean, there's a lot of folks that want to do what they love. For some reason they can't. They still work these jobs forever. And, so that's where I could end up getting as well. Do I want to study ASMR and why we get it? Not really. I mean, you know, I think it's just a social thing. I think it's a thing, for whatever reason, exists in certain people, kind of like being, kind of like having empathy, kind of like having, being a highly sensitive person, you know, they might go hand in hand, actually. I would love to see someone study people that have ASMR and how many of those people have empathy. I know empathy isn't really a genetic. There's a lot of people that think empathy is a trait. I'm not really sure how much study is behind that as far as like genetics and stuff, but I like to think I sway more towards the folks that have studied it and think it's a trait. So I like to see the correlation between ASMR, empathy, and being a highly sensitive person. And if, you know, if you're HSP, then is the percentage 70% that you're also empathetic and that you also experience ASMR, or if you experience ASMR, then is it 75% that your HSP and experience empathy, stuff like that. So, you know, can you be an empathetic person and a highly sensitive person and not have ASMR? I imagine, you know, it's all different combinations of people out there. But I think that the percentages are higher, that they're all kind of related. That's just my kind of mindset. So, favorite indie game I've played so far. That's from IMS Stunts. Indie game, man. I like Limbo a lot. I like Eidolon a lot. I haven't played much of The Long Dark, which I need to get back into as well. That's a tough question. I think those three right there are pretty great. Favorite comic book character from Detux 91. Favorite comic book character. That's a good question. Speaking of comic books, I have to do another comic book video. I don't collect comics anymore. I'm going to pull some comics out of my long boxes and just kind of go over the ones I have collected. Maybe talk about certain series, you know, like Batman Fighting Bane, Death of Robin, Death of Captain America, maybe Blackest Night. And, you know, talk about some other comics that I've collected, you know, as well. All right, I'm going to open up the second one. I think this is perfect. I love the name of this one. It's Founders Dirty Bastard Scotch Style Ale, 8.5%. Might as well just drink wine. Doesn't really say anything else. But we'll open this up as well. Indie ASMR. What H.P. Lovecraft stories have you read? Which one is your favorite? Well, I have one of those Lovecraft, like all those Lovecraft, those books, whether a compilation of his stories. I mean, I like all of them. For some reason, I like Pickman's Model. I like that. Rats in the Walls. There's one where the guy is living in an apartment, and above him, there's someone living in the room, and then something about coming in and out of the window in the room. I'm not sure if he was another. Something was coming for the person, or the person was going in and out. I forget the name of that story. So many great stories. You know, the obvious ones, of course, you know, Reanimator, but it's, what is it called in the book? Is it not called Reanimator, though? It's called, is it called Reanimator in the books? But that one as well. I don't know, how many are there? There's like 20 of them, at least, or so, if not more. 20 good stories. I mean, they're all great. I love H.P. Lovecraft and how he writes. I didn't discover him until my late 20s, I think. And just the way he writes about these horrific things, but without going into the blood and the guts and this great detail, you know. And the way he tells a story and right at the end kind of is the reveal. And it's just great stuff. And it's a shame that, you know, that's, you know, he never really wrote giant novellas or anything. How am I doing? I didn't even pour this. Whoa, that's pretty strong. Okay. Hoping you can hear that. So it's pretty very dark amber. You can kind of see it there, like the light over here. It's got a very, looks like, I would say like it's like a piece of cherry wood, the way the color looks. Pretty strong. scent. My allergies are bothering me, so I don't have the greatest sniffer today. But I'm getting a very interesting aroma there. It's almost like, what is that? That's like bacon. It smells like bacon. Whew. Wow, that's strong. 8.5% ABV Scotch style ale. Now that's probably, I feel like I'm drinking this alcohol. Oh, I mean, hard liquor. Oh, they don't mess around. Ooh, man. That's a strong beer. Hello, Chris from Liverpool, England. The Minecraft for fun. Why is there no next milestone on my Patreon account? You know, I put the Patreon thing up, you know, for two reasons. You know, one, trying to, I can do this for a living, not to solely rely on Patreon or anything like that, but, you know, as a source, perhaps. You know, it's not like I can just sell ASMR albums or something like that or go on tour, right? But, you know, that's part of it. The other thing is some people were asking to contribute, you know, donations and stuff. And I'm not, you know, I don't ever ask, you know, I'm still doing my thing for free that, you know, so there's milestones you can put up there. I can hit $1,000 on this, 1500, whatever this. I know what to put up there. I had, I'll get professional green screen equipment and stuff like that. Well, I figured a way how to do it DIY. I'm actually making a big square frame for my studio with four walls. And I got some green fabric from a local fabric store. And the video I put out with Zed, that was like a trial run for my green screen. I needed to use brighter lights to light up the green screen a little bit more. But I mean, there's no, you know, a lot of people put on the Patreon if they hit this milestone, and they'll do this and this. I don't know, you know, what else to do. I mean, the finances that come in, everything goes towards the channel. More masks, more costumes. You know, it's not like whatever the revenue that I get in, we're always family. We're always going out on these lavish cruises or eating at five-star restaurant every night. No, I'm still here eating pizza. You know, so I put the money into more props, costumes, masks, and, you know, everything sits in my room until I use it for a video. So it's, you know, it's, I don't know what milestones to put up there. You know, there comes a point when I can quit my job, and do something for a living, then I'll let you guys know. But, you know, like I said, it's what it is, I guess. Rofaz or Ropaz, what fictional work has influenced your life the most? That's hard to say. I mean, I think everything has contributed to my unconscious. I mean, everything just goes in, you know, everything we listen to, everything we see gets in there in deep. You're not even aware of it, and it comes out. I mean, David Lynch, you know, the Three Stooges, Jim Carrey. I mean, there's so many types, you know, music and you know, Metallica. There's so many different artists and mediums that have influenced me. It's all in here, and it's big. Soupy thing going on, and that's just you know, I love people who are bold and daring and creative and not just creative, but I love people who aren't afraid to be themselves and they do something and you're just like, it's just amazing. Even they're a musician, they're doing something new and unique within their field. And I love to see that, you know, whether it's someone that draws or, you know, doesn't have to be art necessarily. I love to see people just who aren't afraid to be themselves, to do something that's just out there. And, I think that's great. So, Whisper Rain, hello. I don't know if you're still watching. I'm kind of behind on these comments here, but thank you. If anybody's still watching, check out Whisper Rain, one word. Check out her channel. She's got a lot of great videos. Yeah, having a decent weekend. Hope you are too. All right, Dark Shav Slayer, thanks. He's off to get some food. Andy Sledge, how fast is my internet connection up and down? I honestly haven't checked, but I think it's pushing at least a megabyte up, I think. I mean, we moved into this little place here, and I asked to make sure that our service provider gave us the highest up rate because I don't like uploading videos that take 8 hours. Bear with me, folks. Just trying to Yapshire. What's up, Yapshire? I don't know if you're still watching, listening. He says I should collaborate with Calming Escape. You'll have to ask her if she wants to collaborate with me. You know, I'm always up for whatever, you know. The problem with collaborations is, you know, it's time, people's schedules, the idea, how you want to go about it. You know, the collaborations I would like to do, like a full length back and forth story kind of thing, not necessarily a story, but I kind of prefer, I don't want to do a collaboration where you're just kind of contributing a small part, you know, I want to do like a collaboration like you're doing a movie, you know, you get two actors or whatever. So that's kind of what I prefer. You know, I've only done a couple collabs, I think, not too many, primarily because of all the stuff I mentioned. Hello, we are Thunder Universe from Ontario and everyone else who lives in Canada. Hello, Lisa from Russia. Thank you very much. The Beatles or the Stones? Metallica. Hello, Ashley. That guy, if I could have a perfect pizza, what would it consist of? Chocolate, a chocolate pizza of nothing but pure chocolate. That would be the best, and caramel filled. Just imagine a round piece of chocolate with caramel in the middle. That's the perfect pizza. Hello, Peter. Yankee Doodle, Did I ever watch the TV show Lost? Yeah, like the first season, and then our son was born, and then I never watched TV again, pretty much. So I never finished watching Lost, never finished watching Dexter. Never finished watching Weeds. Those were all great shows. Fortunately, once you have a kid, that pretty much becomes your priority, and there's not much time for anything else. GoPro Jacob, when will the next Whispering Dead video come out? Tomorrow. I usually do the weekly Whispering Dead, so I watch the show, and I get in front of my camera. Hello, Kit Fox. I'm not sure if you're still with us, but you are joining for a bit in the middle of a blizzard. Wow, really? Already? We've got some pretty strong winds out here. I mean, like 30 mile per hour gusts, so I don't know where it's coming from, but I think winter is coming here. In a full force. Hello, Jordan from New Zealand. Can I do a blowing into the mic video, says Carl. Blowing into the mic. Yes and no. I'm not going to just, you know, do the ear, blow in the microphone. You know, if I start doing that, then I might as well start doing kissing videos. So, which I'm going to do. I'm going to do ear-to-ear kissing video, so stay tuned for that. Let's see. AM Video Gaming says he's taking a psychology class right now. Wants to know if ASMR will make its way into that field of study. I would like to see it made in that way of study. I mean, it's a part of the human biology, so it belongs somewhere. Does it belong in psychology, biology? I don't know, you know, but I would like to see someone take it seriously. I mean, it's a definite physical sensation, and you know, why do we experience ASMR? What's the point? You know, is there really a point to it? I mean, I was thinking about this the last couple of days, you know, as far as the purpose of ASMR, I was thinking, you know, we're all watching someone do something, and we're all kind of vicariously thinking, I believe, that they're doing something for us. Whether you're watching someone getting a shave, you're watching someone fix something, I think a lot of people put themselves as if that person is doing for them. I think that's the psychological thing behind it. Is that social aspect, you know? Someone's doing something for you. Someone's giving you some attention. I think that's probably what the core of it is, even though it's not direct. Whether it's indirect, these videos, they're intentionally done for you, you know, to give you that attention directly. Or it's unintentional. Unintentional stuff is kind of a gray area, but I still think it's that whole human thing, you know, that you're not alone, not so much alone, but there's someone doing whatever it is. I mean, it's not like I walk out in the woods and I hear the rustling of leaves and I get ASMR. It usually involves someone doing something, you know. For me, it's I could be on the phone with some guy, you know, trying to sell me something, or call customer service. You know, I wish I had my rotary phone around here, but I'll just use, you know, I call customer service, you know, and they're on the phone, and you know, oh, let me look up just a minute. And you can hear them typing, and they have you right there hanging, and you're just like, oh, this is awesome. Just keep searching. Just don't ever find my name. Keep looking in your systems forever. Please. That's a huge trigger for me. You know, being at the doctor's office, and they're typing away and putting your stuff in. I don't know what that is about that. But I think it's all related that someone's giving you attention. You know, I think that's one of the core aspects of it. So Sinefi wants to know if I'm watching any series. Well, besides The Walking Dead, I started watching Game of Thrones. I watched the very first episode of the first season. That was like 2 or 3 weeks ago. So if I can watch one episode a month, I should be caught up in about 5 or 6 years. And then we'll be able to talk about the show. Let's see. Do I plan on doing any more Magic the Gathering related videos? Andrew, thanks for your question. Yeah, I'd love to do more Magic the Gathering. I want to do a Magic the Gathering like tutorial. What happens with me and the way things go is that I gotta do the salesman I want to do, the couch companion, the plastic pouch, sandwich man. I have to do another Letters for the Apocalypse, and then I want to do, you know, so what happens is I gotta do these first. I haven't done these yet. And these have been things I want to get to. So I get those five done. And then when those done, I'm like, oh, wait, I got these five that I still have to do. So then by the time I want to get around to doing something that I've been wanting to do for a while, that's not like one of these series, it ends up getting put in the back burner. Like kind of like the sounds only, or like the traditional videos, like the beer reviews and stuff. I want to do more traditional stuff. I want to do a paper cups only video. I love that sound of those paper cups, which I have right here, actually. I love these things. I haven't seen too many people do these. I don't know why. I love this. It's great. I mean, it's a tapping sound, but there's that. I'm not sure if you can hear it. You know, it goes from kind of thins out, and then it gets a little deeper when you put the two cups over them, each other. You got a little sticky. You can fill them with beads. Probably, I mean, there's a lot you can do with these things, and I love these things. I haven't seen too many people use these, I don't think. And I'd love to see some more folks use these, because it's got a lot of potential here. Then you got the small ones. Right, then you got the bigger ones. I'm trying to figure out why this is related to the Magic the Gathering question. But you know me, I'm always going off wandering into the woods. But these things are like It's like wizard ASMR right here. That's all you need, paper cups. But so many more people need to use these. I'm telling you. Just awesome. But there's a whole video just doing that. But my point is that there's more Magic the Gathering, yes, and there's also more traditional videos I want to get around to. I just need to be a little bit more conscientious of doing those, because for me, I like to be creative, and the traditional stuff isn't much of a creative thing. But I know there's folks out there who don't like the more creative stuff that I do, you know, so that's cool. And so I just have to do more of those. So all right, so where was I? Am I going to do another Candyman? Yes, I know. Y'all like the Candyman. Thank you. I never really expected that video to do well at all, but Candyman will be visiting. We'll be doing Candyman from space. So I don't know how yet. I want to get like space-themed candy if I can. I don't know if I can or not, but or at least some candy that's space-themed. So that's kind of the next thing I want to do. And I was thinking about actually him showing up to someone that has the alien embryo in their stomach. So the Candyman, you know, the person's got the, you know, Candyman shows up and the person hasn't yet had the alien burst through their chest yet. So I thought that would be great. Hello, Ashley. I don't know if I said hello to you already. Yes, I think I may have. I'm kind of going through some things here. Yes, Calming Escape. I know you have some tattoos if you're still watching. Who is my favorite ASM artist from Smash Adams? I don't like to play favorites. That's not cool because there's a lot of folks out there that I probably don't even know, I'm not aware about, that probably make very good ASMR videos. So, you know, I like, you know, I have some, you know, I like Calming Escape. I like, you know, I like more of the, I've always been this way. I like more of the folks that are lesser known, because I've always been a fan of the underdogs. I've always liked supporting, you know, just like indie music or independent artists. I've always liked liking folks that are less popular, not because they're less popular. And I don't mean to say they're not deserving of being more popular, but, you know, I like, you know, that's, you know, but, yeah, I mean, there's a lot of folks, you know, there's Peaceful Mind, ASMR, sorry, my allergies. You know, Indigo Star, I'm just naming the ones that showed up because I can't remember anybody else. Now, there's also No Stars in the Perimeter. I know he's not a strict ASM artist, but he's very creative. Phoenician Sailor, of course. I just think that guy, he's ridiculous. I mean, aside from the equipment, I like his... I like what he brings to the table. Very creative. You know, not everyone has to be creative when it comes to doing ASMR, but that's just me. That's just what I'm drawn to. I mean, just because you don't make creatively mind-blowing ASMR videos doesn't mean I don't like you. I, you know, that's just the type of person I am. I'm just drawn to the more stuff that's out there. So, you know, so. Hello, Winnie Chen. Saria wants to know, there are a lot of theories surrounding Professor Clemens and how the whole post-apocalyptic scenario fits together. I was wondering if we will ever get a final video culmination to find out what really happened from the professor himself. I'm asking because I want it so bad. I don't know, you know, it's Possibility, you know, I really can't say. Right now, I'm just kind of just rolling with everything. I like everything ambiguous. I like people when I go to watch a movie or I go to watch a show, I like it when they leave things open-ended, even though you hate it. I like it when they leave things up to your imagination. Even if it's part of the plot during the whether it's the ending itself or bits and pieces throughout the movie. That's what I like. Like, that's why I love Lovecraft. You know, he gives you this little short story and he goes into some detail about like what creature is there that he's created or where you're going. But the way he describes things, he doesn't go into a lot of detail, and it's quite abstract. And it's very ambiguous. I love ambiguity. Think it's easy. I think being ambiguous is a challenge. It's easy to just explain things and say this, this, and this, and boom, here's the answer, or ta-da, here's the reveal. I think it kind of takes work to try to in a way, not saying that I'm some great ambiguous creator or anything, but I think it can be a little difficult to try to do that. So I don't think I'm ever going to end. There's ever going to be anything in regards to my characters. That's a definitive answer. So. Looking at some comments here. Favorite track from Pink Floyd's The Wall from Champagne Supernova. Man, that's gonna have to be probably Comfortably Numb. That would have to be the best track, I think. But I don't usually listen to just that song. I usually put Pink Floyd The Wall on, and it's from start to finish. I think the whole thing is just epic. It needs to be listened to that way. Do I like the band Slipknot? I don't. I like Slipknot, yes. I don't like. I'm not a huge fan of that style of music too much. And I heard they have a new album coming out, so I'm kind of pondering purchasing that album. I've never listened. I say I'm not a fan of that style of music, and that's not really fair because I've never really given them or one of their albums a full listen to. So that's kind of not really cool to say. So I've been pondering purchasing their latest album. I mean, I don't know how is it. Is it their best yet? Is it getting rave reviews? I haven't really heard much about it. So, hello, Restful Tingles. I'm doing well, thank you. I hope you do or are doing too. I hope you're doing well also. All right, Calvin ASMR says greetings. This is the first time I've ever actually been around when you've been doing a live stream, so I'm certainly very happy. Me too, thank you. I'm glad you're here. How did you find the house move? So we moved from our house, and we're in a little small place temporarily until we find another more permanent residence. So it was all right. Some things to work out here and there, but can't complain for the most part. I've been recently getting into independent contemporary cinema due to my interest field of photographic still media. Films like Only God Forgives, Lock, The Signal, Blue Ruin, Frank. I have not heard of any of those. Have you ever indulged in that genre of film before? If not, what other kind of art interests you in particular? Independent contemporary cinema. Okay. All right. far as independent cinema, I'm not really sure how to, what to think of about contemporary cinema. I'm not a huge cinephile, so I don't really know what it's considered contemporary. I know what indie is. I love indie stuff. I love indie stuff. First off, I love watching films where you know they have actors that you've never heard of or seen before. So that's one aspect that I love about indie films. The second is they're not these action. Well, I mean, there's action-packed indie films, I'm sure, but to me, a lot of indie films are heavy on characters and story. At least that's what I look for, I think. They're a little more maybe experimental. I love, you know, when I first found about the indie genre, I was just like a new kid with a new toy. I mean, I was renting all kinds of indie films. I can't remember some of the first ones I saw, but I'm not sure. Was that one, Little Miss Sunshine? I think that was an indie film. I love that one. I mean, I can't remember offhand all the different indie flicks. Let the Right One In. I think that might be independent considered, perhaps. The Swedish version. The book was great. What other indie films? I don't know. Is Sling Blade, was that Hollywood? Was that indie? I don't know about that one. That was Billy Bob Thornton. So, I mean, he was an unknown at the time, I think, when that came out. I think. I love indie. I know I haven't really had a chance, though, to really. I've been out of the indie scene as far as films are concerned for just like since our son was born. So I've been so far behind. But Winter's Bone, I think that might be an indie. Love that film. The Road, I'm not sure if that's indie or not. It might not be because it's what's his name. But a big star doesn't necessarily mean it's a Hollywood film. I like Ryan Gosling's films. I'm a huge fan of him and his work. I think he primarily, I'm not sure if he's done anything Hollywood, but Ryan Gosling, I just love him as an actor. The different films that he's been in, Stay, Lars and the Real Girl, United States of Leland. You can tell I'm kind of a huge fan of his work. I like that. Yeah, so I'm a huge fan of indie films and like indie artists and everything like that. So Kudistos Magistos says, the Lovecraft story you forgot the name of is the music of Eric Zahn. Yes, thank you. Yeah. I gotta read these stories again so I can get a little bit more inspired. Someone says I'm using either a poor microphone or maybe the audio is heavily edited before usual uploading. So I'm using my binaural microphones right now in a dummy head. All right, so that's the back of it. I kind of showed everyone earlier in the video. And because we're live, the quality is much less than it would be if I uploaded this. So I apologize, sort of, but not really, for the loss of audio quality. But I stand a lot deeper than probably you'd... you sound a lot deeper than I thought you did, probably due to you usually whispering. Yeah, I'm not really whispering. I probably could whisper, I guess. But placenta fetus. I have no idea what I'm going to do with my life, and college is fast approaching. How do I decide what I'm going to do the rest of my life? Do I even need to go to college? Do I just start work immediately after school? Okay, I knew you were going to, here's what you need to do with your life. You ready? You need to build a spaceship so that you can help us get away from this planet, get away from all the bad people, and we can go find another planet that's just like Earth. And it's just amazing and beautiful. And then we can just create a utopia there. Okay. So don't go to college, go whatever college is that you need to go to, where you can build a space, learn how to build a spaceship. That's what you need to do. And in 10 years, I expect a spaceship that will take us from here to whatever, Aurora 152 of the Gamma Quadrant. All right. But seriously, yeah, you just got to go with what you mean. I don't know what I'm going to do with the rest of my life. And I've got a half of my life over with, pretty much. Just go with what you feel. Trust your intuition. Go with what you feel is right at the moment. When it comes to decisions, if I feel strongly about something, then I know that's a good decision. If I'm like wishy-washy, I don't know this way, I don't know this way, I usually don't make a decision. Something's telling me not to make that decision. So if you're not sure if you should go to college, do you go? I wouldn't go. I mean, because of the finances. I mean, my wife went to college and she's not doing what she went to college for. And there's a lot of people like that, which is a beef I have against college to a degree. Although, you know, it's not like you can just learn how to be a brain surgeon watching the YouTubes. So, but yeah, I mean, you just gotta, you know, if you feel strongly about whatever you're going to school for, you know, then that's probably something telling you that that's what you want to do with your life, right? If you're not really sure, that's tough. That's tough. I wouldn't go and do something just to do it. That's why I never went to college. You know, I didn't know what to do with my life. I could have gone to computers. I'm pretty good with computers. You know, I could have gone for programming, schooling for programming. I don't feel that's where I thought about nursing. More recently, but I don't know if I could actually. For me, the problem is with college or going back to school, especially at my age, it's just having the patience and the fortitude and the commitment. Because like I said, well, I like to go to school, not to be a programmer. Oh, I like to become a nurse, but do I really, you know? So I'm not gonna commit to something that I'm not really, I feel strongly about. So, you know, you just gotta do the best what you think is the right decision, and that's all we ever do. You know, my wife and I, we bought a house and it depreciated terribly. You know, we had to get out of there and sell, and you know, unfortunately, you know, we bought when the market was high and before the bubble burst, and but that's the best we could do, you know. You know, everything is very momentary, from moment to moment, decisions, you know, and you know, it could be a great decision now, 10 years from now, something could happen, and, you know, so, I mean, that's, I'm a guidance counselor, so I can give you the best advice I can. Peach in the Light says, I just watched a horror movie and I'm freaking out. What should I do? Eat gummy bears. Don't like toast? Thoughts on a League of Legends stream or ASMR related video? I don't really know what League of Legends is. I mean, I know it's a video game. I don't really quite understand what type of video game. I haven't really, like, it's like superhero stuff. Sounds like it. Can I talk about those cool masks that you got? I love those videos. I plan on doing a one of those what the heck was that series with the guy selling the stuff in the store? So yeah, I'm probably gonna do one of those again and have all those props. Was it like some kind of, the heck was that video? I know I took it down and I did another one. It wasn't quite the same. Yeah. The Emporium of Euphoria, something or whatever. Hello, Dylan Graves from Canada. Just wondering if you did this question, but when you first started this, if people you knew thought it was rather odd that you do it, or if it's just nothing out of the ordinary for you. I mean, I'm sure there's folks that think it's odd. My family, you know, my parents, my father, and I think my mom have watched a couple of videos. They won't watch certain videos. They won't watch because it's not their cup of tea. My wife doesn't watch ASMR videos. She just watches my videos just to see what the heck I'm doing. It's not like we all sit around, hey, I uploaded a video, come on, let's go watch. Remember the scene from Napoleon Dynamite when Uncle Rico, he's like, you want to see my video? And, you know, that's not like our house, you know, because, you know, my wife would be like, this is the worst video ever made. And what the heck, Kip? Napoleon, how could anyone know that, right? Is that what he says, I think? But, yeah. But, I don't really know who else watches. This is just, I don't want to sound egotistical. I don't want to come across that way, but, you know, a painter has his brushes, his paints, and the canvas. So this is somewhat similar, you know? So all the props are like my paints, I guess. And ASMR is the videos is the canvas. So I just like to paint at night. So how old am I? I'm old. It says Oliver Pebble. Thanks. I'm 40. I'm in my early 40s. I'm going to be a 50-year-old about less than 10 years. Senile ASMR. It's coming. I'm telling you. How you going? How's it going, everybody? Thanks for visiting here tonight. We got some bubble wrap for you. This is bubble wrap here. I picked this up from the store the other day when I was out shopping, you know. Had to pick up some Depends. So I thought I should get some ASMR. So there you go. That'll be in like 10 years, 20 years from now. I'm all out of beer. This is terrible. Why Silky? Will you make any more classic talking fruits ASMR? Yeah, I thought about that. I want to do an ASMR orange. With whispering orange to make satire of the orange, talking orange. What the heck is the name of talking orange? I should know this. The annoying orange. Yeah. I was initially going to do that. I thought that's too easy. Anybody can just make satire of the annoying orange. That's why I've done every fruit besides that, because I don't want to just obviously do, oh, look, he's, no, whatever. The other thing is the beard thing. So it's hard to do a fruit with a beard, but I guess I could. I was going to do the whispering pumpkin. We'll see. I might do some more fruits. We'll see. Jacob, The Walking Dead is on tonight, Paul. Hell yeah. That's what I'm talking about. What's up, Targister Gaming? Naris Lucis, hello. Do I like Russia? Says somebody with a Russian. I have no problem with Russia. I don't really know much about Russia or the Ukraine. I see folks from Russia comment, and I have no idea what they're saying, whether they're making fun of me or they're praising me. But I have no problem with anybody from anywhere. I mean, but I have a problem with you if you're a jerk. So if you're a jerk, you're a jerk, no matter what nationality. But if you're cool, you're cool. Well, that's cool with me. Cool? Cool. Yes, ASMR. Facial hair ASMR. Yes, I will do that, says the anarchist. Do I like the Foo Fighters? Yeah, I like the Foo Fighters. I'm not a huge fan, but I've heard, you know, I know them when I hear them on the radio. Jake Harris says Slipknot's new album is very good. Thank you. Yeah, I'll think about it. All right, someone else says Slipknot. Niels says the new Slipknot album is a good combination of Iowa and the subliminal verses. A couple of emotional songs as well. Greetings from Holland. All right. I'll purchase it maybe. Batman Forever. P. Are you going to... Forever P. Are you going to do any more Mordecai videos? Yes. Mordecai is coming. Yeah, there will be more Mordecai videos. I'm thinking like in a week or two, I think I'll do Mordecai. I just have to get the thing set up so I can hang stuff down and all that. And I can have all the Mordecai goodies. So Gamer Ramen, thank you very much. The Awesome Personist, thank you. Appreciate it. I try my best to do things differently. You know, I don't try to do things different just to be different. Maybe in the beginning of my channel, there was a lot of that inside of me that needed to come out. Now I just try to, I still want to be different and do things unique, but not to say, look at me, I'm different and unique. I'd like to just push myself. Let's do something that nobody really expects to see. I mean, that's part of it too, but it's just, you know, how deep down the rabbit hole can we go? And I'm looking to go down as far as we can go. So the Necrophrygian99 says, I find your normal voice more relaxing than your whisper one. Am I human? No. And you should probably get that checked out. O'Neill joined in halfway through. I think we need to get him kicked out. Everybody should have been watching this from the beginning. And if I find out you haven't been watching from the beginning, forget it. It's over. Now that YouTube has the ability to use 60 FPS, will you be taking advantage of this for future videos? Says Soren. Probably for my gaming videos. I'm not going to use 60 FPS though for my creative stuff because I think it kind of takes away from the cinematic feel. I think 60 FPS is going to make things look very realistic and lifelike, and I think that's great for like GoPro stuff, high action games. But you know, I don't think I'm going to do that for just my regular videos. I'll have to see. I'll have to see what it looks like. I'll probably do maybe one performance video in 60 FPS, but there's not going to be a lot of action. So I don't see why you would want to do 60 FPS. Yeah. So in the games, if my PC can handle 60 FPS at a constant rate, now I'll do it in my games. I don't play a lot of action games, so yeah, I don't know. I guess it might still help. Todd Goodchild. Will I ever do a post-apocalyptic MMO? Is there a post-apocalyptic MMO out there? I don't really know of one. But yeah, I mean, I would do one. At least try. I'm not gonna do an MMO all the way because that would just never end, right? And those things are very, they're like time sinks. Life sinks, actually. Have I ever tried Gamer Ramen? Have I ever tried the Shipyard Pumpkinhead Ale? Not, no. And I'm afraid I might not be able to because it's kind of late in the season now. Anki, ASMR. Hey, Anki, are you still watching? So this is still live. Yes, this is live, actually. Can you believe that? Technology. I got some sinus thing going on. I forgot to take my medicine. Pixel KH, can you do indie film reviews? That would be interesting. Have I done a film indie film review lately? I don't know. I mean, not lately, but have I ever done an indie film review? I don't know if I have or not. I'd love to do more film reviews. What I probably need to do is do a bunch of indie film reviews in one video, like five. Talk about one, talk about each one like for 5 minutes. I could probably do a good number that way. So, Dana McCarthy, glad to hear that you also like Let the Right One In. Joe Costello, do I like the band Alice in Chains? Yes, of course. I love the, is it, what's the album? Is it Dirt? Angry Chair, Rooster, that's the Dirt album, right? I think it's called Dirt. And then the EP. Oh, those are my two favorite by Alice in Chains. The EP, what the heck is it? Jar of Flies. But that I can't listen to that because it's very depressing. Not depressing, I mean, but it's very. I listen to that album, man. I'm just like ready to just like, lay down and die. But Layne Staley, man, just great vocalist. It's a shame that he committed suicide. Flair06 wants to know where ASMR should go next to bring it to a wider audience. I mean, it needs to be out. It needs, as a medium. There needs to be, well, from my point of view, I mean, a film, a feature-length film in the theaters where the audio, at least the audio is very subdued, whispering and stuff, mix of whispering and soft speaking, a lot of that type of stuff. Of course, everybody would probably fall asleep, but, and as far as the visuals, I mean, you could do a regular film without having to do visual ASMR hand motions or anything like that. You could have people, you could have a, it wouldn't be an action film, but you could have an indie film. I can't see why, with ASMR elements to it. But just the dialogue is just like this. It's very subdued and there's a lot of nice, pleasant sounds of glasses clinking and doors being opened and people walking. But And I can't see why. I can't see, and anything is possible. I can't see why that can't be done. And maybe games can introduce that. Whispering in all the different sounds in the environment. So, Jordan Carey. Targister Gaming says, do Kip's voice again. All right. Let me see that. I don't know if I did. I do good Kip's voice. I don't know. I can't really. I don't think I can just do it like that. It's hard. Jordan Carey says, writing coursework in Dracula. What do you think of the idea of the castle being a representation of Dracula? Could this concept of locations representing characters also be applied to Lovecraft's stories? Interesting. Well, Lovecraft was all about these stories. You always end up walking down some steps into some crazy thing, subterranean place that's supposed to drive you insane just from looking at it, because the structures are however the structures are, and there's all kinds of abominations and horrors. So locations representing characters, I'm not an expert on on this, but you think of a dark, brooding, scary castle in a film, and you think Dracula, you think monsters, right? So I guess if there was more films of Lovecraft stuff, and you thought of subterranean, what's the word? Architecture, however Lovecraft describe it. If you saw that, I guess you would think of his characters and stuff. I mean, yeah, so yeah, I guess, I'm no expert though. So have I, Zargos 269, have I traveled much in my life? If so, where? And if you haven't as much as you would have liked, where would you like to go? Thanks for your question. I haven't traveled much. I mean, I went to Mexico on our honeymoon, went to see my brother on the West Coast. That's about it. I love to go to the Orkney Isles, Stonehenge, rainforests, everywhere, really. Anything with just, I love to go to a lot of places out overseas in Europe, or anywhere really. I mean, I want to get out of the United States and just go international. There's a lot of places I love to go, anything involving just a lot of unique landscapes and things like that would be great. Anki ASMR wants to know, how do I feel? How do you feel about having a secret? Sincerely. Okay. How do I feel about having a secret? I don't know. It depends on what the secret is, I guess. It's hard to say. Oh, let's see. Cobster Fox says, hey, don't like toast. Okay, so there's a game called Rift. I have played it for a long time. It's an MMO. It has a backstory of Rift and sending people back in time. Maybe you could have a look into the backstory and do a video on it. All right, I'll take a look if I can. Sounds interesting. The MMO thing, man. Those things are such time sinks, though. Titusville Tourist Board wants to know if I follow the podcast. Welcome to Night Vale. I've heard of that. But no, I mean, I don't follow it. I don't have time to follow any podcast, let alone any TV series, as much as I would like. I've heard a lot of people mention Night Vale ever since I was on YouTube. So, yeah, I have to get around to that one of these days. Virtus Roman, hello, and thank you. Some of my favorite video games ever made. Oh, man, we're going back to the Commodore 64, back to the Atari. Well, for the Atari 2600, I would have to say Venture, you know, where you're that little square and you have to get the arrow to kill the dragons. And then you have to pick up the key to get to the castle and avoid the bat that wants to steal your key or your arrow, or your sword. For the Commodore 64, that would be Wasteland. And then the SSI's Dungeons and Dragons series of games. And then early PC days was like Space Quest, King's Quest, Out of This World, which was actually in an Amiga port. That was an amazing game. Monkey Island. Zork series, which I can never finish because I'm just not very smart. And Duke Nukem, you know, Counter-Strike. I had so many countless nights staying up till 5 in the morning and getting 2 hours sleep before going to work playing Counter-Strike with a friend. Doom, of course, Unreal, when that first came out. I didn't like that. I mean, it was okay. I mean, the Unreal Engine was great, but the game itself was all right. Last of Us, of course, Fallout 3, Ico, Shadow of the Colossus. Half-Life, of course. I played Half-Life 2. Half-Life 2 was good, but Half-Life 2 gave me motion sickness. That was weird. I've never experienced motion sickness from a game before, and Half-Life 2, whew, I was getting like that, like almost every game. It was crazy. Other great games. There's so many. You know, of course, currently Skyrim. The first Dark Souls, the first game, that was awesome. Never played anything like that before. What else? Other games. Those crazy games, like Monkey Island, I think it was from LucasArts. There's a whole bunch of those adventure games like that. I can't remember them offhand. But those are great. Trying to think of something more recent. Uncharted series. Great stuff. Let me think. What else? I said Half-Life. I feel like I'm missing something that I should be saying. The Batman games were cool. Arkham City, whatever it was. I mean, there's a lot of good games. I played Outlast, and Outlast was great. I was going to do a let's play of that, and then I recorded the first video, and I got into this this one room, and it was like an intense jump scare in the beginning of the game where someone killed themselves. I didn't scream or anything, but I kind of jumped, and I think I banged my mouse. I was like, okay, you know, I don't think I can record this kind of game if it's going to be like this, and there's going to be a lot of me banging, you know, dropping my mouse because I'm scared of getting these jump scares. But and I don't think there's just that kind of game is really intense and scary and gross. Not gross, but you know, some people might think it's kind of gross. But Outlast was great. But you know, after a while, once I met Traeger, at that point, I was just like, you know, the jump scare thing, it's getting old. I just want to finish this game at this point. Find the three things to unlock the next thing. And so by the time I got to the ending, I was just running through the game because I knew what I had to do. I had to go here. I had to go run to do the three things and then come back and then do the next thing to get past. And then I had enough of getting of being just tortured and scared. It was great for the first half up to the Traeger point. And then after the Traeger scene, I guess after that, I was just like, you know what? It's kind of, you know, want to get over with. Because it was kind of intense too. And I couldn't bear any more of it. That was a great game though. And then some current games I think are great are the Alien Isolation. I think it's a great way for those that love the Alien films to kind of relive that experience. I haven't gotten very far yet, I know. So I'm really looking forward to seeing what's upcoming in that. And then, you know, some of the Long Dark and Eidolon or Eidolon. I forget how you pronounce that. So, yeah. All right. I know I'm kind of behind on a lot of your I know there's a little bit of a delay here between when you get your comments and when I read them. So Brandon Ellis wants to know if I like England. I don't have a reason to not like it, so I don't really know much about it. So I have no problem with England. Thank you, Azistol. Benny wants to know if I'm a fan of Eminem's music. I don't like Eminem because of the fact of his, you know, his lyrics against gays. You know, I don't, you know, maybe I'm old school. You know, when he first came out, you know, he was a young guy, right? Young adult, and he had a lot of pent-up anger and all this. But now the dude is like in his 30s. I don't know if he's 40 yet. He's in his 30s, and he's still talking about hating on, you know, he writing lyrics that I thought were very anti-gay. And I'm thinking to myself, aren't you kind of past that stage now? You know, you should be writing something a little bit more intelligent, or are you still angry? So I don't know I don't know Eminem personally, but to keep writing about those kind of lyrics, I'm like, you know, whatever. You know, if you're still insecure, if you're doing that just to be over the top, I don't see a need for it. If you're doing that because you still have some insecurity issues, then you need to address those issues. I don't see the point. I mean, I don't listen to a lot of bands, and the bands that I like don't talk about that stuff. I just don't understand that at all. I don't understand why that needs to be in lyrics. And call me a fuddy-duddy or whatever, but you know, that's one reason. That's probably the one thing that would probably would prevent me from ever listening and liking Eminem is that. So yeah, I don't really care what people think about that, you know. Hey Lloyd's ASMR, can't wait till your next Walking Dead review. Thank you. It should be out tomorrow. I'm assuming you watch too. By the way, if you haven't, check out Lloyd's ASMR, his channel. He put out this amazing hour length ASMR video, which is just fantastic. And I don't think I watched it, but I don't think I commented on it. But, you know, the one thing that kind of pisses me off about a lot of people in the ASMR community is certain folks seem to pat each other on the back when their videos are very pretty or special effects and all this. But when you have a guy like Lloyd's ASMR who did this hour length video with multiple scenes, focusing on different, you know, it wasn't very low tech, very creative, and you know, he didn't do any kissing sounds in it. I'm sure he probably could have played a police officer that was kissing you, but it's just a fantastic video that he did, and deserves a huge boatload of credit for that. Just because of the kind of time and effort that will go into something like that. I mean, he multiple scenes, different kind of props and costumes. I mean, he did this whole scenario, which was just amazing. And really, Lloyd, I mean, you deserve so much great recognition for that video alone. I mean, I know what it takes to go into that. You know, whatever you're working with is just, it's great. So yeah, definitely check out his channel. Sometimes I think we get caught up with all the surface stuff. I don't want to get too much off into that subject. Andre Roman says, what time is it here in Italy? It's 2200 hours. Ah, man, you doing military hours on me? That's 11 o'clock at night. Right now it's 4:30 p.m. So, actually the wife and kids should probably be coming home soon because, he went to see his friend. We had to go clean up some stuff at the old house, throw a bunch of stuff out. So he went to visit a friend and hang out for a little bit. So I should probably end this probably pretty soon before they come. God, it's 4:30 already. Where did I start this? Like 2 o'clock. Hello, Venue Leader. Dragon Lad wants to know how is Deep One Dave in his videos? I don't know. You'll have to ask Deep One Dave when he does a live session. So yeah, I want to do live sessions of my characters. But I wanted to do this first because I know a lot of folks just kind of enjoy me not being in character. So Cody the RB, do I like Pearl Jam? Hell yeah, man. Who doesn't like Pearl Jam? I like the first album they put out. You know, I'm not a huge fan, but actually the first two albums, God, I can't remember. I'm not a huge fan. I don't know the songs, but the first album and then the follow-up with Daughter. I think the song was called Daughter, right? Don't call me daughter. I think that's how it goes, I think. Just another gamer. Can I play DayZ? I tried playing DayZ and it's just so wonky. The graphics are, the controls is just, at least a month or two ago, it was very unpolished. And I was wandering around doing nothing. I love the game and the potential, but at least when I was playing it like 2 months ago, I'm just walking around. I don't see anybody or anything, and there's a couple zombies that came up to me. I don't know. We'll see. Mike Elmore, I should do a Rocky Horror Picture Show review. I should, as Margaret. I've got to watch that. I've seen it like once or twice way back in the day. I've got to watch that again. Yeah. So. Thank you, Desert Eagle, for the Deep One Dave support. Golden Globe 99, tell us your best joke. Man. I mean, there's only two jokes that pop into my mind, and one of them is not very nice. The one I do know is very lame, but I like it. So, how's it go? God, it's one that my dad told me like a long time ago. I'm gonna have to think about that before I tell it, because I'm gonna screw it up. Do I play PS3 games? Yes, I have. I do play PS3 games, but the problem is that this room is like considered my studio. It's like a spare bedroom. It's like a 10 by 10 room, 8 feet high. So the PlayStation is out in the living room, like many, many feet away, many inches, hundreds of inches away. And I don't have a hundreds of inches cord that's going to stretch from my PlayStation to my PC to record. I don't have a PS4. I think a PS4 streams. I'm not sure if it creates YouTube videos or not, or whatever format it records in. So I need to get a many hundreds of inches cord that goes from my computer to many hundreds of inches away to where my PlayStation is. If I want to start recording some of those games. But most of the games I have on the PS3, I have here on my PC now. So someone wants to know, where is the Halloween tradition video? And that is of me eating Halloween candy. I know, it's very disappointing. I thought about doing the candy eating video, but number one, we didn't give out for candy because of where we live right now. We don't get a lot of trick-or-treaters. And number two, my son does have a boatload of candy, but I haven't yet come to grips with taking from it to eat his candy. I just haven't done that video, and I probably might not, to everyone's disappointment, and I apologize, but So girly, Golden Globe says, we all seen manly ASMR. How about a girly ASMR? Oh yeah. There's going to be a ASMR for women. I'm not sure who's going to do it yet. So, Lie here or Lee here wants to know, do you like hockey? If so, what is your favorite team? It would have to be the Flyers. At least it was. I don't watch any sports now. I used to watch football. I'd watch the NFL. Of course, I will. I was a huge Dallas Cowboys fan. As far as hockey, it would be the Flyers. But I don't watch sports anymore. I love to sit back and watch a game, but I'm just, time is limited, so. Mark Larux says, give me some of that amazing whisper of yours. It has helped me go to sleep for over a year now. I'm listening to this from my bed on my tablet, and I should really go to sleep already. It's 11 p.m. here, and I have school tomorrow. Okay, well, I'm not really going to whisper in this video too much, so I really want to apologize, but maybe in another video I will whisper you to bed. Mac, did I say Mark? Mac LaRue. Okay, so actually I have a new service now. If you pay me $1,000, I'll actually show up and whisper to you beside your bed. I can climb in through your window and just, it'll be cool. No, your neighbors won't see me, and I'll just whisper you to sleep. Okay, so think about it. It's only $1,000. If you order now, $900. All right, so Bob the Attic Cat says BBC Radio is experimenting with binaural microphones at the moment. How about ASMR on their radio? Really? Are you serious? BBC Radio is using binaural microphones? That's interesting. Huh. I wonder why they're using that. If they started using that because of what the ASMR community, of how popular those microphones are, that's pretty interesting. ASMR on the radio. Yeah. I know people are like, oh, you know, ASMR on the radio, people be falling asleep while driving. I don't see that the case. I listen to ASMR videos on my commute all the time. I mean, it's over my data connection. So not all the time, but when I know I have some data, I listen to some short ASMR videos, but you know, I don't fall asleep, but it's cool just to chill out, especially at work. I listen to ASMR videos at work. Radio, TV, whatever. There should be like an ASMR channel where you can just turn and chat. I mean, TV, and you know, TV sucks for the most part, besides the cool series like Game of Thrones and stuff. But back in the day, there used to be real nature videos. Marty Stouffer's Wild America, National Geo, Omaha, Mutual of Omaha. We're going back ways, old school. But Jacques Cousteau, there should be some great nature shows, man. It was very subdued. I mean, just, and then Bob Ross, you know, right? All the Ian Can Cook, all those. Justin, the guy from the, that New Orleans guy used to cook. I forget what his name was. But yeah, there used to be, you know, TV anymore is now, it's all, it sucks. It's even worse than what it was. It's now, it's everything is reality show TV, or it's, you know, you go on the Nature Channel and it's just, it's over the top, you know, man versus wild, or top 10 violent, most scary, dangerous animals. There's not, you know, that's all, but that's what, because that's what sells is the stuff that, you know, get your attention. No one wants to sit there and watch a show, a documentary about a dung beetle. Well, I do, but you know, apparently not a lot of people do. But yeah, I mean, there should be an ASMR channel, you know, why not? You turn on this channel and it's just a great way to fall asleep too, you know? So ASMR, you know, shopping network. So. Otisawa, I think I might have pronounced that. Otisawa. Have I ever considered getting endorsements from people like Dolby or DTS who specialize in multi-channel audio systems? Maybe they could hook you up with nice equipment and pave the way for ASMR in surround, or even ATMOS, which I have no idea what that is. I'm not really looking for endorsements. I mean, I appreciate it. You looking out for me and all that. I'm not really looking to get hooked up, and that's not why I'm here. So I've kind of looked into that, into one aspect for something, just to maybe get a break on a price. But that was kind of a one-time thing, and it didn't work out. But I'm not really here to use, you know, my, I want to say popularity, but you know, I'm not looking to get hooked up. That's pretty much it. But I mean, I don't know what else to do besides binaural. I had the binaural mics, you know, so, you know, that, you know, I'm pretty cool with buying what I need to buy from whoever I need to buy from. So I'm not looking to get too crazy. All right. Anki ASMR Tingling says, now on a more serious note, there is a saying in Danish, if you do like you always have done, you'll get what you have always gotten. What is your view on that? Any examples? If you do like you always have done, you'll get what you have always gotten. Man, you're making me think. Is that like a karma thing? Goes around, comes around? Is that, or is that like where are you, or is that like where if you just keep doing the same thing, you're always going to get the same results? I can address the karma thing, which I don't think what that is. I think karma is pretty interesting. I know a lot of people don't put much into synchronicity, but I've seen a lot of things happen in my life, which are just kind of really more than just coincidence. I think there is some karma, but maybe what we think is karma is just people who are very not nice, who just always end up getting what they deserve for always for not being nice. So we think it's karma, but you know, as far as if you do like you always have done, you'll get what you have always gotten. It sounds like if you're just doing, if you never change, if you just keep doing the same thing, then you're just going to keep getting the same results. That's what I think. That's what you're getting at. I'm not sure how to answer that. I think there is some reason I want to say that I think there are some people who think they deserve more or deserve something different for doing the same thing, or for not doing something different. Like they, you know, feel entitled. There's that aspect. I think there's you think that you should be somewhere or have something more than what you have, but you haven't really done anything to change that. I mean, in this world we live in, unfortunately, it's very economy driven, right? So you want to get somewhere in life. You want to have a nice house or a fancy car or whatever you want to, you know, upgrade equipment, or you want to just move, or you want to pursue your dream. It all costs money, right? So you can either just, they say it's achieving your dreams and all this, you could just keep doing the same thing you're doing and not trying something different, not challenging yourself, not trying to pursue opportunities that might improve your education or your work history and all this, and then complain that I've been doing this for 20 years, I hate everybody because I don't live in a mansion. Well, you're not really doing anything to improve your life. You're not really trying to not to sound cruel. I mean, there are some people that have physical or mental limitations, and I'm not talking about those folks, but I mean, if you're just an average person and you're capable of doing more, but you're not doing your best, or you're not trying to improve, and you just think you should have life handed to you, well, that's not going to happen. I mean, what you do, if you keep doing the same things you've done, you're going to get the same things you've always gotten. That's the world we live in, right? You want to make more money, well, you're going to have to earn it, unfortunately. But as far as I'm not trying to come across like I know everything, but I mean, I think if you want change, if you have expectations of your life and you want more and you want things to change, I think you have to do something more than what you've done in the past. And you're going to have to make some changes and maybe some soul searching as well. That's kind of the life we live in. The world we live in, it's very economic based. Well, it is it, you know, financial based. But even if you want people, different people in your life, or you want, you know, let's forget about jobs or a house and think about, you know, just having more different friends. Well, you know, if you keep acting the same way that you've always acted, you're going to end up, you know, with the same kind of friends or not having friends or whatever it is. But I'm hoping this is what that question is about, but if you change, then I think changes will happen. I mean, that's what I like to do. That's what I like is always doing something different, trying something different, because same thing isn't working. Well, trying something new, trying something different can't hurt. Can't be any worse. Well, it could be any worse, but you can learn from the experience. Audrey Prouty wants to know if I ever feel awkward filming while people are home, like having to ask them to be quiet. Normally I film when everyone's asleep. That's mainly for the silence, the quiet aspect of it. I've filmed before when people were around, not too often. And the distraction there is knowing that they can make some unwanted sounds. If I have someone watching me, in the beginning, it might feel awkward. But I can zone it into where I need to be, the headspace. I'm very control freak when it comes to the videos. So I prefer, instead of, you know, shut up, I'm trying to make a video, I'll wait for everybody to go to sleep. And well, besides, I want to spend time with my son and my family anyway. Right now they're, you know, my son is out visiting someone, a friend. So I had this extra time today. But that's why I wait for at night. It's quiet. I don't have to struggle trying to fight people to be quiet. So yeah. The awkward thing would come in to play is if I had to, my only choice was to film when people were still awake. That would be very frustrating, I can imagine. Hello, Tyler Thomas. Commander Colin wants to know how I'm liking Alien Isolation so far. I love it. Like I said, I think it lives up to the original Alien film, but I haven't gotten very far into it yet. Of course, there's more people, you're in this different environment, but I like the atmosphere and feel the graphics visually. So I really can't wait to get further into that video. It's just taking me forever. Like I said, I'm limited. I'm not like one of these. I'm not like PewDiePie, who I don't know what the hell he does. And just play games all day long, you know, but I unfortunately don't have that. I have to work a job and I have a family, so I can only put out so many videos a week. Things were differently, I'd have probably Alien Isolation finished by now, but the awesome personist. Have I ever seen American Horror Story? No, but I've heard some good things. I heard the first season was great. It was based in an asylum, I think. I'm not sure. I think they're on the third or fourth season now. And I know every year it's a different plot line. I didn't know that at first. I love, like I said, I just don't have time to watch all these. different series as much as I would love to. There's a lot of like Game of Thrones and stuff. Going through the comments here. Hello, the Leftless from the Netherlands. Thank you. Kenshin Mitsuhara. Have I ever seen the film Mr. Nobody? No, unfortunately. I don't think I have. It's a personal favorite of mine involving choice and the butterfly effect, as well as quantum concepts and a whole bunch of other awesome, crazy sci-fi stuff, but yet all relating back to love and emotions. Special effects and story are truly beautiful and incredible. I feel that you'd enjoy it. I don't think I've seen that one, Mr. Nobody. Let me just look this up real quick. Jared Leto was in that. Damn, I didn't know that. I like him. I like him in Requiem for a Dream. And didn't he play the transgender character? I think it was transgender or transsexual in that one movie that came out a year or two ago. I'd love to see that too. That reminds me of the other movie, Monster, which I thought was great. But I've not seen Mr. Nobody. I'm going to have to watch that. I've heard someone talk about that before, mentioned that before, so thank you. Stonewall wants to know why I would visit the Orkney Isles. I don't know. There's just something, I've seen pictures of it, and it just seems like some interesting place to visit. Rebellion, did I play Grim Fandango? I've played it briefly a couple years ago, but I've never really got into it much. But I love the style of it and such. Don't Like Toast says there are a lot of Skyrim mods out there that you could use to make your Let's Play different, like Helgen Reborn. Has a fantastic backstory and lore to it. I will be getting back around to my Let's Plays of Skyrim. I've added some visual mods and stuff. As far as additional mods like stories and such, I haven't added that stuff to it. I don't like to kind of add that kind of content, take away or what might possibly break the original story. I'm not sure if that's possible, but I haven't even finished the original Skyrim, which is gonna take me forever. But I need to get back around that too. So thanks. Kenneth Parker says I should do more Zork ASMR. Yeah, the reason I haven't gotten back to Zork is because I'm not too smart. And unless I use a walkthrough, I'm never gonna finish that game. But I think I've thought about playing some retro games, so we'll see. Myst. I've never played Myst. I've seen it. I may do a playthrough of Myst just because it's one of those retro games. I know the graphics are great and all that. Lincoln's TV says, as a Swede, I just wanted to say that I laughed my ass off when in your manly ASMR video you said cojones means meatballs in Swedish. Yeah, that was just, you know, me trying to be funny. Of course, I know it doesn't mean that, but do I watch Cotton Candy Addict? Do you by any chance watch Markiplier's videos? He has an amazing voice. Just saying. I don't think I do. I'll have to check him out. Thank you. Let's see. Samu Vaverta asks, do I like racing games? I don't mind them. I'm not that good at them. Oops. I've played like old school racing games, like Pole Position for Atari 2600. I was pretty good at that. I'm not really big into cars and stuff, so yeah. What's up, Amnic Gaming? Lincoln's TV, how do I feel about so many people misinterpreting your manly ASMR video? Yeah, I had a feeling that a lot of people, I was somewhat concerned that a lot of people might take that. I'm not worried about gaining or losing subscribers. I mean, I love everybody that subscribes, don't get me wrong. I've never, I still do what I've done since day one. I just do a thing and hope that people like it. I don't try to do a thing to gain subscribers or views. Of course, if I did, I wouldn't do Margaret and I wouldn't dress up as a woman or a woman thing, a thing, whatever that looks like maybe a woman, or do the manly thing. I expected people to not get it. I'm baffled by people somewhat that don't get the fact that I'm being over the top. I mean, it's YouTube, it's 2014. I can understand this was like 1950 and I was doing that kind of video. But I mean, if you're on YouTube, I mean, if you've gotten to my video and I mean, how do you really get insulted? I don't get that, I mean, I can understand being insulted by that, the guy down south, who talked about putting the gays in the fence and then just dropping them food supplies until they die off, whatever that preacher. That guy was, I can understand being sold by that video because that was not, I mean, that dude was real. That was a guy in front of a congregation. I mean, that's kind of scary. But I don't know. I mean, people are just, I just don't understand. I know there's trolls and people are trying to pretend they're offended, for the sake of trolling or whatever. But I mean, and I can understand people being offended for me swearing, but and I can understand people maybe being offended because they don't know me, and they think I'm really, so there's that too. They think I'm really trying to be sexist, but it's just one of those things, people, a lot of people just aren't exposed to a lot of things, I guess. I don't know how to say it. So I just laugh. I don't know how to take people's comments because I'm really offended. And it seems like they're really offended, but I don't know if they're trolling or what. But so I think we all need to take ourselves a lot less seriously than we do. There's too many people are too serious about themselves. Hello, Dark Arrow. Thank you. Mecha Heart. I still live in PA. Yes, I'm outside. I'm west of Philadelphia. My mic is low. Yeah, I'm using my binaural microphones. I mean, so I can turn them up. Might turn them up a little bit here. That might help. But yeah, I don't really know how low they are. this is kind of the setting as I record with. This is also live, so the quality is going to be a little bit less. Heavy bullet, my thoughts on Michael Jackson. I thought Michael Jackson was a great artist. I don't know him as a person. All those allegations of sexual child abuse and all that. I mean, I think, you know, I think some of the folks are really creative. To be really creative, you're not quite anchored in on land as probably, you know, to solid ground as you should be. And that's not necessarily a bad thing. I'm just trying to say that I think some of the folks who are really creative, you know, are just out there in a good way. I don't really know Michael Jackson, and as a person, you know, I'm not really gonna, I don't really know what to say about all that stuff. As far as an artist, man, he was just insanely good. I mean, there's no doubt about that. His dancing, his voice, it's a shame what happened and what he became. And that could just been a product of how he grew up and raised, and he was abused either mentally, physically, or whatever happened to him in his personal life. And that's a shame, because he was just amazing person. And I think he had so much potential, and just something kind of caused him to go a little left center too far, and remain that way. I don't really know what he did as far as charities and stuff. But I'm not going to knock the guy at all. You know, I think, I don't really know. I can't knock him, because I don't really know, you know, what he may have done. But and I'll give him more credit, I think, than I would if, I'll give him more credit than not, I guess I'll say. Am I going to do, Ruth wants to know if I'm going to be doing another chocolate testing video or tasting. Yeah, I would love to. I haven't done one in a while. I know I haven't done, you know, I still have to do the Halloween candy eating video, which I didn't do. And I'm not sure if it's going to happen, but my son does have a ton of candy. And me taking, you know, 2% of his stash, I don't think he's really going to care. I thought about going out, actually, to the supermarket and just getting some stuff that's half off. That would be better, because then I have all that candy to myself. I think I'll probably do. I'm not sure. At this point, there's going to be a Halloween candy eating video. It's kind of after the fact, but maybe I'll just give you guys a candy eating video anyway, just to make up for that, you know. So, the brother, Bear the Viking, wants to know if I'm going to bring back Brother or the Whisperer in the future. And yes, I've been thinking about the Brother. We went to see Cirque du Soleil. Yesterday, and that was just amazing. It was I forget the name, it starts with the V, whatever tour it is. It was great. And there was one particular guy, actor, who had this great face paint, and it was kind of inspiring. But I want to do the Brother again, definitely. I feel that kind of happening a little sooner. Probably I'm not going to go out, though. I don't really feel like I'm going out in the woods and doing it. I'll probably do it here and just green screen the background, or black. I think I'm going to do another Brother with white. Maybe make make the beard and everything white, and do some contrast stuff with some black somewhere, a line up here, and kind of a black outline, maybe some. Something here, dots or something, and then the whole white face. So I want to do Brother again. I know a lot of people enjoy that, and thank you. And that's something I want to kind of do again. It's just been a lot of these things just take figuring out how I want to do it and when it feels right. I don't like to force anything. So, and the whisperer, the guy with the mask, I guess, I would like to do something like him, based in Gotham. I just haven't found out how to do it right. Indigo Stars asks, she really wants to do a girl equivalent of the manly video. Not sure if I could pull off the same quality as yours, though. I know what you're trying to say. Like, you can't think you'd do as good as me or whatever. But, you know, I see folks from time to time, they seem to be focused on comparing themselves. And you shouldn't do that. If you feel good about something, just do it. And don't try to compare. Just do it your way. Do your thing. And feel confident about it. And if you feel confident about it, it'll come through. And if you don't feel confident about it, don't do it at that point. Especially if you feel it's not going to compare to something, because apparently you're not very confident because you're trying to compare it. Just do your thing. Don't worry about comparisons. You know, that's, you know, there's how many billions of people on this planet? And while there's a select few of us that make ASMR videos, just because I have an idea and three other people have the same idea, and one of those people do it first and then I do it, doesn't mean we're stealing off of each other. Doesn't mean it's a competition. A lot of creative folks have a lot of the same ideas. So, if someone did the same thing you were thinking of, it doesn't, I thought I was going to do that. And that happened to me. So now, all right, so don't do the same thing, but do it your way and do a little differently. So, how many people have done the same kind of haircut or ASMR videos? Nothing wrong with that. You know, people like the plain Jane ASMR videos, and that's fine. Indigo, if you're really looking to do that, I would love to see someone do the female version. No holds barred, run with it, of the manly, and do a female thing and do a satirical. That'd be great. I'd love to see more female creators do stuff that is risky. I love to see people take risks. I love that. Because they're not afraid. I love people who aren't afraid. And maybe that says a little about something about me. Always afraid, maybe growing up or whatever, of doing certain things because we're afraid of what people might think of us or something. But so you should do it, Indigo. And don't worry about whether it compares or not. All right, I'm probably going to maybe another half an hour of this live stream. God, it's been like forever. I wasn't really expecting to do this too long. Kane Stein LP says, did you know you got mentioned by the morning show, Good Mythical Morning? Here on YouTube, they picked the manly ASMR video as typical representation for the ASMR section of YouTube. Yeah, I know. Good Mythical Morning, I don't know what to make of those guys. I know a lot of people watch them. I think they're all right. I'm not really going to sit here and judge them one way or the other. But I was aware of the of them using. I saw my comments all of a sudden was like, Good Mythical Morning brought me here. Hey, AR, it's only Good Mythical Morning. Did you know that? Yeah. It was cool. It was cool for them to show the video. I don't know what to say. It was cool, but it brought a lot of interesting, it was good and bad. You know, there was folks that I think came to the video or the channel and didn't know what to think of it or me. But, you know, that's the risk that I take for being here. Something that I accept. I mean, you know, you got to. I'm getting a little off topic, but yeah. As far as it representing ASMR, yeah, I mean, you know, they didn't really pick that, I don't think, just to represent it. I think it was just kind of, I don't know why they picked it, honestly. But all right, let's see. Eric Furno says, are you a fan of Smashing Pumpkins? Yeah, I love Smashing Pumpkins. I actually have album, the double album on my iPhone. The Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness. That's, I know the album that came out after that. What the heck was that? Was that A Door? I think it's, or A Door is the song that's on it. But I like Melancholy. To me, that's like their, my favorite of theirs. Hello, Ognib. Ognib. And thank you. Comrade Farrow wants to know if I've seen the film A Clockwork Orange. Yes. And that was, man, some scenes in that movie were pretty sick, in a bad way. But I liked the film itself. It was crazy. It was good. Hello, Carlos Duarte. Kolsky wants to know if I get tingles from my own videos. No. I don't. I don't get, yeah. Don't like toast. Says, do you feel like people are scared of ASMR? They might actually experience it, but not a big fan of listening to it because of embarrassment or sensitivity, so they just avoid it altogether. Hey, you know, it's very, you know, if you're not, I don't know how to put it, if you're not a YouTuber, if you're not watching YouTube videos, and you're kind of, or you're not on the internet a lot, and, you know, I don't want to say particular age group, I mean, I don't want to, you know, but maybe whatever reason that you're not up to date with maybe certain things that are going on, you know, I don't want to say hip, but you know what I mean. Yeah, I can see folks, you know, well, you're probably going to have a reaction you see on YouTube, but if you're not always on YouTube watching videos, when I say YouTuber, I mean whether you're a viewer or a creator. You know, if you're just not on YouTube a lot and you're not aware of the culture, so to speak, and all the different types of the videos and AS, and you stumble upon an ASMR video and you see someone kissing the camera or you know, wearing a mask and a wig, or any other thing, any other videos, and you feel embarrassed or to watch it, even though you get the sensation. I can see some people being put off by it and having a negative reaction to it, and thinking it's weird and crazy and all this. But I think that's just, that just speaks to the insecurities that they have. You know, we all, you know, there's always a driving factor behind everything that we do and say, for the most part, you know, especially if it's negative. A lot of folks, you know, Carl Jung said, we will see ourselves, what did he say? How did he say it? We will see ourselves in the faces of 1,000 people or 1,000 faces throughout our lifetime. And meaning that, you know, there are other people out there who are doing the things or acting a certain way or saying the things that we wish we could, or things that we fear or whatever, and they bring, and they are the personification of that which we haven't really. This is just my layman's approach or view. They're being a certain way that we haven't addressed yet or come to grips with or accepted, and that kind of speaks to a part of us that is an insecurity, maybe, you know. Which a lot of people, you know, why do a lot of people hate certain people? Because they don't understand. They haven't come to an understanding of this, or they hate a certain type of music, or they have a fear of this or fear of that or whatever it might be. But I think that's the same kind of thing. I mean, you know, if you know, fear, uncomfortableness, it's something that that person hasn't addressed yet. All right, folks. I think I'm talked out, and I'd love to spend another 8 hours here with y'all. I am going to log off. Let me just hit a couple more questions here and say hello. Decisive Recourse says, what is your background as an artist? Did you discover ASMR and suddenly find an outlet for your creativity? Yes, pretty much. I've always enjoyed writing lyrics, song lyrics, you know, I wouldn't say poetry, but more like song lyrics. Dabbled in guitar, dabbled in keyboards, dabbled in electronic music, made American flutes, you know, all this stuff, you know, Photoshop and all this. I just couldn't figure out what I wanted to do. And I love sound, high affinity for sound, and love being creative. And ASMR is just this medium. So it all came together. So Snow Bunny, what is the secret to get famous on YouTube? Prank videos. Prank videos and ear-to-ear kissing and breathing sounds. If you're a woman, I mean, if you're a guy doing kissing, ASMR kissing video, it's probably not going to work because the YouTube, I wish I could show you a picture. YouTube says that my viewers are 70% male. So if I was to start doing a kissing video, I don't think it would work out too well. But if I was a woman and I was pretty and I was doing a kissing video, I put one video out and I'd probably get like 50,000 subscribers one day. All right. G the G says, favorite porn category. Oh, man. That's easy. That would be PVC on copper pipe porn. That's the best, man. Doesn't get any better than that. All right, I'm out, guys and gals. Thank you for watching. I gotta take a break. I gotta drink some water or something, and whatever. And I got big family coming home soon. So thanks everyone for watching. I got the Walking Dead video coming up tomorrow. The Whispering Dead, and I got the ASMR of a Salesman. I got the Sandwich Man. I got the Peculiar Plastic Pouch Predicament and the Couch Companion videos coming up. And that's really it in the foreseeable future, as well as some gaming videos. So thanks, everyone. Sorry if the audio quality or video quality wasn't the best, but hopefully this was still kind of chill and learned some things and we had some fun and hung out. And I'll try to do these at least once a month. going forward. That's really it. All right. So thanks. And I don't have anything else special to say besides bye. And thanks for watching. Tingle on. All right. Take care. Bye.